Hello, my name is Martin and this is 3D Printing Iceland. In this video I'm going to test out the strength of a PETG filament printed out with different part cooling fan speeds. So let's have a look after the intro. So in this video I decided to try out strength of layer adhesion based on cooling amount for the part cooling fan. I did a review of a PETG from IC33 the other day and got a comment on that video that I might want to reduce the part cooling to get better layer adhesion. So I decided to print out a few samples with different part cooling fan speeds to see how the layer adhesion would turn out to be. And for that I have made a small apparatus to measure out the strength, and I have done a video on my channel where I talk about the design of this device. It's a device that pulls the part in a somewhat controlled way, and I have a scale to measure out the force needed to break the parts. So I'm going to set it up for breaking those parts I have and show you the results. So here are the parts I've printed out. Those are with 100% speed on the fan, 80%, 60, 40, 20 and 0. So they all have different curing temperatures, so to speak. And I'm going to set them up in the device and record the values on the phone and write down the results. So I'm going to play out time lapse of this operation. It takes a while to set up, but I place a part in here and align this up. Then I take the strap from the scale and place it over the part. Then I start the video recording on the phone and turn on the scale so it will show the value. And then I pull on this part here, and then part breaks. So that's the operation. And now I have to run through all the samples. Those were two parts with 100% fan speed. Now I've done the tests and I have to look at the video to see the values, and I'm gonna do that. So here I am in Premiere and I'm just looking at the timeline, and here's the point where the part broke. So when I play it out, I can zoom in and see the point or the value of the scale when the part broke. And here I can see it's breaking at 3.53 kilos. So I will write that down and I will go through all the clips with the brake tests and write down the results and put it in a Excel sheet. So here are the results of the strength tests, and I had two pieces for fan speed, so the numbers are an average of those two tests. And maybe this one was a little bit off, but the trend line is obvious. As the fan speed goes down, the strength of the filament or layer adhesion goes up. So from 40 to 0% part cooling fan, it's almost doubled in strength. So if you're printing with this PETG filament, it's obvious that you get better layer adhesion by turning down the fan speed. And in the initial tests I did, I was having the fan speed at 100%, but I really should maybe have it at 20 or 25% or even less, depending on the model and if there were bridges and steep overhangs. But if the part doesn't have any bridging, you could really slow down the part cooling fan and get a stronger part. So there's an obvious trend here with a steep steep average increase in strength. So this was from 3.68 kilograms to 11.58 kilograms. So that's a lot of difference in strength of the filaments depending on part cooling speed. So that was the purpose of this video, to find out if I would get better layer adhesion by lowering the part cooling fan. And it was obvious part cooling does affect greatly the layer adhesion. So for this PETG filament, I really should have turned down the part cooling fan for the test I did to get better strength. Maybe you have to adjust depending on the model if you need part cooling for bridges and on steep overhangs. Or if it's a part that doesn't have that, then you can really slow down the part cooling to get stronger parts. But this will be it for this video. This was a great test, like the first somewhat scientific test I've done for this channel, and it was good fun, and I could use my device I did earlier, so that was good. So I thank you for watching this video, and I hope you subscribe and like and comment on this video, and I will see you in the next one.